Hello students, in the previous lecture I did discuss the static indeterminacy. Now in this lecture I am going to discuss specifically the static indeterminacy of beams. As we know, beam is a horizontal member, or to be specific, it is a horizontal structural member which supports transverse loading. In the previous lecture I did tell you that internal indeterminacy of beams is zero, because in case of beams, once we get the reactions at the supports, then the rest of the beam can be easily analyzed. I'm saying rest of the beam means the internal actions, that is shear force, bending moment, etc., can be easily obtained once the reactions at the supports are known to us. And that is why in case of beams, DSC, that is degree of external static indeterminacy, is equal to total degree of static indeterminacy, as DSI is zero. So we'll not be going for the internal static indeterminacy, and we'll be going only for external static indeterminacy in this case. Now here I have shown number of beams, and I am going to get the degree of static indeterminacy for these beams. Again, DSE, that is external degree of static indeterminacy, is equal to R minus 3 for the structures which are called as plane structures or the 2D structures. Beam is also a planar structure, and as such DSE is equal to R minus 3. R is equal to what? The number of reaction components which are unknown to us, and 3 is the number of equilibrium equations. But here we will have to make one adjustment. See, I have shown 3 beams over here. All of these 3 beams are fixed beams. The only difference is that here in the first 2 cases I have shown the loading, whereas in the third case of this fixed beam I haven't shown the loading. So I am going to tell what is the difference actually which is taking place over here. Now in the first case, the beam is fixed and the loading is shown, but it is not a vertical loading. In the second case, I have shown the vertical loads only. So here I have shown the general case of loading. It is called a general case of loading. Now fixed support, as you know, it provides 3 reaction components: the vertical reaction component, the horizontal reaction component, and the moment component. So 3 reaction components at the left end, 3 reaction components at the right end. This is what which is known to us. So there are total 6 number of reaction components. So R is equal to 6 over here. Whereas number of equilibrium equations is 3. See again, the total number of equilibrium equations is equal to 3 for a plane structure. But here I am using one specific word, equations. When we go for equations, it means available number of equations. So here it is a plane structure, and available total number of equations is 3, and available number of equations is also 3, and that is why DSE is equal to R minus 3, which is equal to 6 minus 3 is 3. So degree of static indeterminacy for this type of beam with both the ends fixed and the general type of loading, DSE is equal to 3, and hence DS is also equal to 3. Now let us go to the second question. The difference between these two is that it is called a general loading, whereas it is a vertical loading. Now see the difference which takes place over here. Now here, what are the unknown reaction components? That is the question. Unknown reaction component over here is vertical component of reaction. The horizontal component of reaction is 0 over here. Remember it well. Horizontal component of reaction is 0. Horizontal component of reaction is 0 over here. As such, there are only 2 unknown reaction components at the right end and 2 unknown reaction components at the left end. So the total number of unknown reaction components is equal to 4, and the number of available equations over here is only 2, because out of the three equilibrium equations, summation fx 0, summation fy 0 and summation m is equal to 0, the first equation, that is summation fx is equal to 0, is of no use. And that is why out of three, only two can be used. The equations which can be used are summation fy is equal to 0 and summation m is equal to 0. So as such, the number of available equilibrium equations is 2, and that is why DSE is equal to 4 minus 2, which is equal to 2. So this beam, that is fixed beam with vertical loading, is statically indeterminate to degree 2, whereas the same fixed beam with general type of loading is statically indeterminate to degree 3. Now let us go to the third one. Now in the third case, I have shown the fixed beam only. I haven't shown the loading. So the question is, what is to be done over here if the load is not shown? Now remember it well, if the load is not shown on the beam, you will have to consider the general loading. So you know, the loading can be of any type, that is, if this is the case of general loading, and if it is the general loading, this problem is similar to this one, and degree of static indeterminacy in this case is equal to 3. So this fixed beam with no loading shown, here we will have to consider the general case of loading, and as such the degree of static indeterminacy over here in the third case is equal to 3. Now let us consider the fourth case. It is a continuous beam, the number of supports is more than 2, there are 3 supports. Now the unknown reaction components over here are 2, the vertical component, the horizontal component. The unknown reaction component over here is 1, which is vertical component. The unknown reaction component over here is 1 again. So there are 1, 2 and these 2, total unknown reaction components is equal to 4. Total unknown reaction components is equal to 4. So R is equal to 4 over here. Whereas number of equations, now again available number of equations, the actual number of equations are 3. But again, available number of equations depends upon the type of loading. So what is the type of loading over here? Is the loading shown? It is not shown. As it is not shown, we will have to consider the loading as general case of loading. And that is why the number of equations available is equal to 3. As such, degree of static indeterminacy in this case is equal to 4 minus 3, that is 1. So have you got this one? So if the loading is not shown, you will have to consider the general case of loading, and as such the total number of equations, equilibrium equations, becomes the available number of equations. Now in this case, here I have shown two hinges over here. So these are the internal hinges. In this beam, there are two additional provisions over here. So rollers are provided over here. This type of support is called as vertical shear release support, whereas it is a roller support. Now when the beam of desired length is not available in the market, two or more beams are connected end to end by means of internal hinges or are roller supported over one another to get the beam of a desired length. So such a beam is called as compound beam. So these two are the compound beams. Now let us go with the degree of static indeterminacy. Here unknown reaction components are, now is the loading shown? The loading is not shown. So we'll have to consider the general case of loading. As such, number of reactions, reaction components at the left support will be 3, at the right support will also be 3. So total number of reaction components is 6. Now what are the number of equations which are available? Now number of equilibrium equations available is equal to 3, because it is a case of general case of loading. But so total number of equilibrium equations is 3. But again, if an internal hinge is provided, we get one additional equilibrium equation, because we know that such an internal hinge cannot transfer moment. So if I name this hinge at C, moment at C is 0. If I name this hinge at D, moment at D is also 0. So we get two additional equilibrium conditions, that is MC and MD is equal to 0. As such, 3 plus 2, that is 5 number of equations are available for this beam, and degree of static indeterminacy for this particular beam is R minus available equations. So available equations is 5. Equations is 5 because 3 plus 2, so 5. 6 minus 5 is 1. So degree of static indeterminacy is 1 in this case. Now let us go to this question number 6. Here it is again a compound beam. Loading is not shown. As loading is not shown, we will have to consider the general case of loading. If general case of loading is there are two supports at the ends. So here, three unknown reaction components. At the right support also, three unknown reaction components. Total unknown reaction components is 6. Whereas, number of available equations are, equilibrium equations are. Now for plane structure, the total number of equilibrium equations is 3, and which are all available over here because the case of loading is general case of loading. So equations is 3. Again, if we consider this joint over here, it is called as vertical shear release joint. So this type of support will not provide a reaction in vertically upward direction. As such, the shear force along vertical direction over there is 0, and that is why we get one additional condition over there. So because it is a vertical shear release support. Now here at this support, it is a roller support, and at roller support, the horizontal movement is possible. So horizontal shear can be released. At the same time, the moment at support C or at this point is 0. So moment is 0 at this point. At the same time, axial movement along this direction is possible. So two equations are available over here. One equation is available over here. And that is why the total number of equations which are available is 6. The unknown reaction components is 6. And that is why degree of static indeterminacy for this beam is 0. 6 minus 6, that is 0. So this is how you can work out the degree of static indeterminacy for beams. Now in the next lecture, I am going to discuss the degree of static indeterminacy for pin jointed plane structures. Thanks.